Vimeo is the thinking person's YouTube. It's full of people doing proper film projects who hold things like vision and creativity. There are very few dramatic chipmunks on Vimeo. There is, however, now an app, and it's better than YouTube's. It can do all the stuff you want, such as browsing for videos, reading and adding to comments, and even the ability to build and access a watch later list, which I love, love, love. But the standout feature is the recordings tab. This allows you to film and do some basic video editing. You can stitch clips together, set the in and out points, and even add either a sepia or heat effect. You can export these videos or upload them straight to Vimeo from within the app. It's worth noting that you can't do as much editing in this app as you can in iMovie, but it's also worth noting that this app is completely free. The My Videos tab is also a bit of a goldmine, allowing you to share and add your videos to groups or channels, change the Creative Commons license for the video, and view statistics, amongst other things. Vimeo, seriously, well done. You totally, totally rock. If you're under 18, look away now. Not because I'm about to talk about rude stuff, but because you're probably unfamiliar with the design of the classic 80s MIDI system, and so this might blow your mind. Stereolizer is a pretty amazing iPad app and definitely has mind-blowing potential. It's the home of thousands of radio stations from around the world, and you can choose numerous stations to set as your preset 1, 2, or 3. Tune to a station, navigate the nostalgic FM fuzz, and then comes the fun bit. Press record on the tape recorder and record songs off the radio just like the old days. When you stop the tape, it'll come pre-named with the station and time, or you can change the name. These tapes will then reside in the My Recording section, accessible via the eject button. It's a beautifully designed app, although perhaps not 100% on the right side of copyright. But turning a carefully blind eye to that side, it's definitely worth the £1.19 charge. Sharing. Encouraged by your mother whilst you were growing up, and yet very much discouraged by Steve Jobs now you are grown up. Confusing. Eavesdrop for the iPhone is not going to find many fans in Cupertino, but it's got a fan right here. It allows you to share music with another iPhone owner without the need to have one earphone each, since it does so over Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. It's a case of each of you downloading the app for £1.19, and once it's open on each of the phones, one of you takes the role of DJ and picks a song to share. The DJ phone will then show up on the listener's peers list, and once you've connected, you'll be sharing the song in real time. As a nod to providing some way of paying the artists, you can search for the song on iTunes or bookmark it to search for later. Totally 100% Apple friendly? Probably not, so get it whilst it's still in store.
We've already covered iPlayer on BlackBerry and iPad, so you may well ask, why are we covering on Android too? Because it might possibly be the best iPlayer app out there. That's why, doubting viewer. It obviously does all the iPlayer things you'd expect, like letting you watch TV programmes from the last 7 days, stream live broadcasts, and all that replay-y TV-y stuff. But what makes it better is the fact that while the iOS version only runs on iPads, not iPhones, you can use the Android app on any Froyo device, no matter the screen size, although the interface can look a bit quirky on less standard display sizes. You also need Flash 10.1 installed, but Android fans, you can totally have that, and Steve Jobs can't do a darn thing to stop you. The interface is also simpler to navigate, making it easier to find things like live TV and radio streaming straight from a menu, rather than digging down into the program guide. Since you pay your license fee, you might as well download this app onto each and every Android device you have, just because you can.
My computer and my mobile being totally synced is the ultimate dream. After world peace, obviously. Firefox has taken a brave step into my dream world, albeit for Android. If you're a Firefox Android user, you need to download the latest version, both for your computer and mobile, pronto. Once you've linked your phone and desktop, you'll then have access on your phone to your Firefox bookmarks, the history of tabs you've opened on your desktop, as well as the tabs currently open there. If that isn't freaking magical enough, each page comes with site options, including saving it as a PDF and searching within the page. Add-on fans will find a wealth of the kind of Firefox add-ons you're used to on the desktop version, such as various skins or pop-up blockers. Finally, searching itself is also awesome, thanks to the self-proclaimed awesome bar, which will guess what you're trying to get to based on what you've looked at on your computer. Android owners, you win again. Want more? Go to www.frackulous.com/follow for a glut of RSS-y, iTunes-y, podcast-y, subscription-y options.